today's our topic of discussion is acceptance sampling. In the last lecture, we have discussed briefly about this acceptance sampling. So what exactly meaning of acceptance sampling? It is nothing but we are taking out a random sample from the given lot, and that we are inspecting. After inspection, we are deciding whether to accept that lot or reject that lot. So that method is known as acceptance sampling. Now this acceptance sampling is done before the actual process or after the process. It is not during the process. Process control is during the process, but sampling is done before actually carrying out the process or after completion of the process. Now this acceptance sampling is carried out where there is a quantity is too large, so cost involved for that inspection is too much, so we cannot inspect 100% part. So in that case, we go for the acceptance sampling, random sampling. Then if there is a destructive type of testing, so we cannot carry out this testing for every part, so in that case we are going for the acceptance sampling. Then when we have very short time, in case of we have to produce the result and we don't have that much time to inspect all the parts, so in all such cases we are going for the acceptance sampling. That is, instead of doing the 100% inspection for every part, we are randomly selecting few parts and we are inspecting that few part, and based on that inspection result we are deciding whether to accept the whole lot or not. So this is about acceptance sampling. Now for carrying out the acceptance sampling, we have to design the sample plan. What is the sample plan? It is nothing but decision about the certain parameters. First one, that is first parameter we have to know before doing the actual sampling or designing of the sample, that is size of the lot. It is denoted by capital N, size of the lot. Then size of the sample, that is small n. First we decide for selecting any sampling plan, first we have to decide the lot size, size of the lot size capital N, then size of the sample, sample size small n. Okay, suppose we are having the 10,000 component, that is a lot size capital N. After that, out of that we are taking only 10 component for inspection, that is your sample size. Then number of defects, that is selection criteria. While inspecting, what parameter or what selection criteria we are deciding? Suppose out of 10, if you are getting 3 components defective, then I will select the lot, or below 3, then I will select the lot. And if you are getting more than 3 defective components from that 10, the whole lot will be rejected. That is a selection criteria, that is denoted by C. Then level of confidence, means that is acceptance level, how much it is expressed in terms of probability. Okay, so 0 to 1, if it is a decimal value, it can be 0 to 1. Level of confidence, that is probability of acceptance, that is it is a probability, so we are expressing it in terms of 0 to 1 or 1 to 100%. In terms of percentage, it is 0. In terms of digit, it is 0 to 1. In terms of percentage, it is 1% to 100%. So we can express it in a both way. Okay, so these 4 parameters we first decide for a sampling plan. Now what are the types of the sampling plan? Single, double and multiple. It is extension of double sampling plan. So what is single sampling plan? So for single sampling plan, we have capital N. We have capital N, okay. Then we have a sample, this is a lot size, then we have sample size, and we have selection criteria, that is number of defects. Suppose take the example, we have 1,000 components. So out of that 1,000, we are inspecting 10 components, that is your sample size, And if suppose we decide the selection criteria as a 2, meaning is that when you are inspecting this 10 component, out of that if you have got more than 2 defective, then whole lot will be rejected. If you are after inspection, if you are getting C value as a 3, that number of defective as a 3, then whole lot will be rejected, sent back to the supplier. If suppose that value we are getting 1, then whole lot will be selected. So this is a case of single sampling plan. Now what is double sampling plan? Okay. Now this is, in this case we are having only one deciding criteria. Suppose now take the example second. This is about single sampling plan. Now double sampling plan. Now what exactly the double sampling plan? Now previously we are having suppose n is equal to 1000 components. Okay. Now sample size we have selected 15. Now we have selected C1, a first selection criteria. Okay, about 3. Now after that, if you are doing the inspection as per your sampling plan, and if you found that we got C1 value is equal to 3. After inspecting these 15 components, if you got that, we found 3 components defective. Now we feel that this 3 component defective is not sufficient to decide the fate of this whole lot. So for that, what happened? We will take again one more criteria. Instead of having one single selection criteria, we are having the range. We are having the range for this selection criteria. Suppose 3 to 5. Okay. Now, if you are inspecting, this is your range. If you are getting less than 3, suppose if you are getting after inspection, if you are getting defective part as a 2, we will directly reject this lot. But what if you are getting a part that is in between 3 to 5? Suppose if you are getting 4 part defective, now we have selection criteria minimum level 3, maximum level 5. Now we have in between that is 4. So we cannot decide whether to select or reject the lot. So in that case, we are going for the second selection criteria. Now again we are taking the this is N1. Again we are taking second number of samples from this given lot of 1000. Okay, suppose we have taken again N2. Suppose we have taken the 10 parts. Now again for that 10, we are checking the selection criteria of 5. Okay. Now if you are inspecting this 10 parts, and out of that if you are getting 5 part defective. Now this 5, and initially how much we got? 3. So 3 plus 5, total 8. So we are deciding on this total factor whether to select this lot or not. Okay. So both the defective counts were taken into consideration for deciding in case of double sampling plan. We are taking 2 sample size. In case of double sampling plan, we are taking 2 sample size. And while deciding, instead of taking just one value of the selection criteria, we are taking 2 values, and we are taking addition of that, and based on addition of these 2, we are deciding whether to select a given lot or not. This is called as double sampling plan. Okay. Multiple sampling plan is just extension of that. Okay. It is just shown graphically. Okay. We are having, this is your lower level, this is your upper level. Okay. If in between that, in first inspection, if you are getting the lot, defective lot, in between lower and upper, then we are going for the second inspection. And in after doing the second inspection, we are adding these 2. First defective lot, second defective lot, addition of these 2. And based on these 2, we are deciding whether to accept the lot or reject the lot. So this is a double sampling plan. Now extension of that is a multiple sampling plan. Okay. Triple, quadruple. Likewise, we are having the number of sampling plans. Depending upon the your criteria, we can decide which plan we have to adapt. Okay. Generally, decision of this plan is based on the cost and time. What cost we have? Because for this sampling inspection, we require the operator, we require the more time to carry out this inspection. So cost and time that is needed to decide which type of sampling plan we have to adopt. Then acceptance sampling, purpose is just to determine the quality level. Acceptance sampling is an auditing tool. It is not a quality development tool. Acceptance sampling is an auditing tool. Like is your control chart, which are a quality improvement tool. Okay, that will inspect the quality of the process during actually carrying out the process. But this acceptance sampling we are doing before or after. So it just give the result about the quality. It doesn't help to improve the quality. Okay, that is the purpose of this acceptance sampling. Now this whole parameters about sampling plans are drawn on the chart that is called as operating characteristics curve, OC curve, shortly called as OC curve. The parameters which require for the design of the sample plans are graphically shown on the operating characteristics curves. Okay, so operating characteristics curve is a graphical representation of probability of acceptance. This is your confidence level. What level of confidence we want? That is the probability of acceptance. Okay, it is a OC curve is a graphical representation of probability of acceptance versus lot quality. So this is a lot quality, that is the percentage of defective. Now this acceptance sampling is generally used for attribute type of data. What is mean by attribute data? This acceptance sampling phenomena is generally used for attribute data. This technique we are not using for variable type of data. We are using it for attribute type of data. What is attribute data? Either we have attribute data means that is percent defective. Percent defective or it can be defect. A percent defective and defect, these are the two terms which seems similar but are different. Percent defective is related with the number of components. 100 components we are inspecting and 10 are we found defective. This is a percent defective. So 10 out of 100 will get the percent defective value. Defect is related with the single component. Defects are related with the single component. So after inspecting a single cylindrical block of engine cylindrical block, if you have inspected and if you found number of defects on that block, this is called as defect. Okay, so it is related with the single component. Percent defective is related with the number of components. Defect is related with the single component. So both these data is called as attribute type of data. It is a quality structure, not quantity. It is about quality characteristics of that component. Okay, so acceptance sampling is suitable for attribute type of data. So on this axis we are having either defect or percent defective. So on this x-axis we are having either percent defective value or defect value. On the y-axis we are having probability of acceptance, that is PA, which is denoted by small PA. Okay, so on a y-axis we are having PA and here on x-axis we are having a lot quality. That quality characteristics we are expressing either in terms of defective, percent defective or defect. Now from this direction to this direction, lot quality goes on decreasing, and from this point to this point probability of acceptance goes on increasing. So this is a zero level. Probability is always expressed in terms of 0 to 1. Probability is always expressed in terms of 0 to 1. If it are expressing in terms of digital value. If you are expressing probability in terms of percentage, we are using 1 to 100%. Okay. So now suppose probability value is 0.5. What is the percentage of probability of acceptance? If probability PA value is 0.5, what is the meaning in terms of percentage? It is equal to 50%. Okay. If it is 0.05, it is equal to 5%. Okay. So this is nothing but the probability of acceptance. So here we are shown 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4, 0.5, 0.6, 0.8, 0.9, last one. Okay. So 0 to 1. So 0.1 means what is the level of probability of acceptance? It is a 10%. 0.2 is a 20%. 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100%. Okay. So this is a probability level. This probability level, if you are deciding, we are going to decide first it before deciding the sampling plan. This is a confidence level, probability of acceptance. First we decide how much probability of acceptance we want. Okay. So that is predetermined. Here we are having the lot quality. After inspection, for how much defects we will get this defect, probability acceptance that we are getting from this graph. Okay. Suppose now take the case of first this. Okay, take the case. Now suppose we are having 3% defective. These are the levels of defective, percentage of defective: 0, 5%, 10%, 15%, 20%. Okay, likewise 30% and so on. So level of lot quality goes on decreasing and probability of acceptance goes on increasing in this direction. Take the example, suppose your lot quality is having 3% defective, that is 0.3. If you are 3% defective, that we are having 0.3 defective part. 3% defective means if you are inspecting 100 parts, out of that 3 are defective. This is the meaning of 3% defective. If you are inspecting 100 parts, out of that you found that 3 parts are having the defective parts, 3 parts are defective. So if your lot quality has 3% defective components, then probability of acceptance for that will be, if you project that, we'll get probability of acceptance as a 90%. For 3% defective, we are getting 90% probability of acceptance. What is the meaning of that? Meaning is that if your probability of acceptance 90%, meaning is that we are accepting 90% job. If you are sending number of times job for inspection, out of that 90% jobs will be accepted. That job will be accepted. That is the meaning of probability of acceptance. If there is a 3% defective, it is having 90% probability of acceptance. This is from experimental investigation. This value we are getting from experimental investigation. Now take the case, second, worst case. Now this is 20.20. If you are having the 20% defective, meaning is that out of 100, suppose if you are having the 20 parts defective, you are inspecting 100 parts, and if you found that out of 20 parts are defective, your lot quality is 20% defective. Now for that, just project that value to the curve, we'll get the probability of acceptance. Now for that, we are having 5% acceptance level. If there is a 20 parts in the 100 components, 20 parts are defective, there is only 5% chance to accept that lot. If you are sending 100 parts and in that you know that there are 20 parts are defective, then there is only 5% probability that lot will be accepted. This is the meaning of probability of acceptance. Okay. So as it goes on increasing, there is a deterioration, decreasing the quality of the lot, there is a decreasing in the probability of acceptance also. As the quality goes on decreasing, there is a decreasing in the level of the probability of acceptance. For low lot quality, we are having lot quality decreasing in this manner. For this low lot quality, we are having very low value of the probability of acceptance. For a high value of, or we can say very low percentage of defective, we are getting high value of probability of acceptance. So we have taken the two cases. One case where we are taking lot quality as a 3% defective. 100 component you have inspected, 3 are defective. We are having probability of acceptance 90%. That lot will be accepted in terms of probability 90% time. 90% is the probability of acceptance. Suppose if you are having a 20 defective parts after inspecting 100 parts, in that case we are having only 5% probability. If you are sending that part to the vendor, at that time that vendor will have the ability to accept that part only 5%. So that is the meaning of probability of acceptance. So it will show for a particular lot quality what is the probability of acceptance. From this graph, what we will come to know, if in a given lot, for a given lot, if you know this much parts are defective, we will come to know what is the probability that lot will get accepted. Okay, so that we are getting, that information we are getting from this operating characteristics curve, or shortly called as OC curve. Now take the example, now this one. Now if you are having the 5% defective, what will be the probability of acceptance? Take the example, suppose we are having the 5% defective, means this level 0.05, it is indicate your defects are 5. What is the meaning of that? If you are having the 100 parts, 5 parts are defective. You know that out of this 100, 5 parts are defective. If you send that part to the customer, okay. Now this is your lot quality, 5% defective. Now what should be the probability of acceptance that we will get from, if you project that, okay. So we will get this value, here about this value. So from this graph, we will come to know for 5%, what should be the probability of acceptance. So it is near about 80%. So if you are sending a lot of 100 having 5 components defective, then that lot will be selected having the probability of 80%. 80% that lot will be selected. 30% is the probability that lot will not be selected. Though there are 5 components defective, there is a chances that that lot will be selected is 80%. Probability of acceptance is a probability. So it is a, in terms of chance, it is not determined value. It is just chance. Meaning is that if you are doing that activity 100 times, 80 times it will be selected, 20 times it will be rejected. That is the meaning of probability. To understand this concept of probability of acceptance, we know the basic fundamental of probability. What is the meaning of probability? If the probability, if you are saying that probability of acceptance is 80%, if you are doing that activity, suppose 100 times, 80 times it will be selected. 80 times it will be selected, 20 times it will be rejected. This is for smaller sample, okay, but we cannot predict it. In real life, this is a theoretical probability. This is just theoretical probability. It will, in real life, it will not happen such. It will not happen in a real life such that if you are sending a lot of 100 having 5 defects, so it will select it 80 times and it will reject it 20 times. In real life, it will happen that you will get 100 times rejection. Now how this is a indication of this value, what is the importance? This is for a big sample size. Suppose if you are sending that lot 10,000 times. Now instead of 100, your activity is number of times is increased. 10,000 times. So out of that 10,000, 8,000 times it will be selected and 2,000 times it will be rejected. This is the meaning of probability. Okay. This is just theoretical value. It will just give brief idea about theoretical value. As the size of the sample or number of activities goes on increasing, for that this theoretical value holds true. It is not for smaller value. Suppose if you are same, now take this example, if you are sending that for 10 times, you are sending 100 components having 5% defective. If you are sending 100 components and in that we know that 5 components are defective, if you are repeating that activity 10 times, probability of acceptance said it is a 80%. Meaning is that 8 times your job will be selected and 2 times your job will be rejected. But this is just a theoretical probability. As we are going on increasing this value, 10 instead of 100, we will get near to the 80%. If you are getting for 1000, we will get more closer to the 80%. 10,000, lakh, crore. Okay? So in that, as your sample size goes on increasing, this value holds true. This is not true for smaller value. So that is the meaning of probability. So that's why it is called as theoretical probability. So probability of acceptance, it is just a theoretical probability. It is just a chance. Okay? So this is the significance of OC curve. OC curve, from we will come to know, this is your defective level, then what is the probability that lot will be accepted. This is the significance of this OC curve. Now from this, for this lot quality, there are two terms are used for that purpose. First one is known as acceptance quality level, AQL. Two terms we are using for defining the quality. To define the lot quality, on the x-axis we are having the lot quality. So to define that lot quality, two terms we are using. First one is called as AQ, okay, acceptance, AQL. First one is known as acceptance quality level, and second one, lot tolerance percent defective. AQL and LTP, these are the quantitative levels. These are the two quantitative levels at two different probability of acceptance. This is a probability of acceptance quantitative level for the lot quality. For the producer, it is called as producer risk. Okay? That is called as producer risk, and this one is called as consumer risk. This lot quality level is called as consumer risk. This lot quality level is called as producer risk. It is denoted by alpha and this one is denoted by beta. These are the two quantitative terms which are used to express the lot quality. Now lot quality related with this AQL is called as producer risk, denoted by alpha. That PA, probability of acceptance, is denoted expressed in terms of alpha, it is called as producer risk. At this level, what will be the probability of acceptance? That is expressed in terms of beta, and that is called as consumer risk. Okay. Now, what exactly this producer risk and consumer risk, that will come to know from this graph. Now, take the example of this one. We are having lot quality defective level is a 3%. For that, for 3%, probability of acceptance is 90%. Take the example, we are taking that 3% lots are defective. Meaning is that if you are sending 100 lots, 100 components, three components are defective, that is known to you. This is meaning we are having a 3% defective level. Lot quality level is 3%. For that 3%, what is the probability of acceptance? It is near about 88%, or you can say 85%. probability of acceptance for this 3% lot is 85%. Now this is a probability of acceptance. Now whatever the remaining part, that is called as producer risk. Remaining probability, now this is a probability of acceptance is 85%. So remaining 15% is your producer risk. That is denoted by alpha. Are you getting? Probability of acceptance for a 3% defective part is 85%. Now remaining 15% is your producer risk. We are producing that part, 50% probability of acceptance, remaining probability of acceptance is called as producer risk, which is denoted by alpha. This is called as producer risk. Okay. Now, and level related with this producer risk is called as AQL. This level is known as, this lot quality level is known as acceptance quality level. This level 3%, this 3% level is never known as AQL. You are sending 100 components. We know that 3% components are defective. If you send that part, that 85% probability that part will be accepted, means all whole 100 parts will be accepted, is 85%. 15% possibility that will be rejected, and that 15% is known as your producer risk, which is denoted by alpha. And this 3% quality level, we know that out of this 100 we send, 3 are defective, is known as acceptance quality level. That quality is known as acceptance quality level. Consumer knows that this is the level which consumer knows that out of this 100, consumer also know out of this 100, hundreds are not a correct part. There are 3 parts which are defective, but customer is willing to accept even know that 3% parts are defective. So this level is known as AQL. This is a minimum level of defective that consumer want to accept even if it knows it is having some portion defective. That portion is called as AQL, acceptance quality level. Now second parameter, that is called as lot tolerance percent defective. It is related with the consumer risk. Okay. First one is related with the producer risk. Now we are having a 2 terms. First one AQL, okay, that is producer risk, which is denoted by alpha. Second LTPD, that is lot tolerance percent defective, that is known as consumer risk, which is denoted by beta. Okay, so quantitative level of lot quality which consumer want to accept, willing to accept, that is AQL, and this is a lowest level of the quality consumer want to accept. Okay, that is called as consumer risk, denoted by beta. Now what is consumer risk? Suppose, now take the example, we are having 15% defective, meaning is that if you are sending 100 parts, 15 parts are defective. So lot quality is 15%. Your lot quality is 15%. So what is the probability for this lot quality 15%? Just project it, we'll get the probability level for that. Okay, so we are getting probability level near about 18. So probability of acceptance at that point near about 18%. Near about, it is near about 18%. Okay, so that is nothing but your consumer risk, and that is given by beta value. This probability of acceptance at 50% lot quality is your consumer risk, which is denoted by beta. So this value is a consumer risk. that probability of unacceptable is accepted. Unacceptable means because you are having very low quality. 100 part in that 15 parts are defective. So quality level is low. So even that this 15 parts will be accepted. This is unacceptable thing. 100 parts inspected that 15 parts are defective. Still it is accepted. This is unaccepted thing. Defective parts is unaccepted thing. This unaccepted is accepted. 100 out of 15, this is unaccepted thing. That is accepted, it is having the probability of 18%. And that is called as consumerism, which is denoted by beta value. Okay. Unaccepted, it accepted, is a consumerism, which is denoted by beta. Accepted is rejected. That is producer risk, which is denoted by alpha. There are two things related with these two terms. What is producer risk? That is alpha. What is the producer risk? Acceptable is rejected. What is acceptable is rejected. Now we are having the 5, only 3%, 3 pass defective, probability of acceptance we are getting 85%. So 50% probability alpha is 50%. So 50% chance that acceptable is rejected. 85% will be selected. If you are having 3 pass defective out of 100, 85% 5 times it will be selected, but 50% time it will be rejected. So that acceptable is rejected is 50% time. This level is acceptable. This acceptable is rejected is a producer risk. Consumer risk is a beta, and that is unacceptable. Unacceptable is accepted. Okay, we have taken the case of this 15%. Okay, out of 100, 15 parts are defective. Now, what is the probability of acceptance of such lot quality? That is 18%. Okay, so consumer risk, this much is an unacceptable thing. So this, even it contains 15 parts out of 100 defective, still it is accepted. What is the probability? That is 18%. So this is called as consumer risk. So producer risk and consumer risk, these are the two important things we have to know before designing the sampling plans. And that we are getting from this OC or operating characteristics curve. Lot quality level, which is correspond to the producer risk, is called as, what is the lot quality level to this one? Producer risk. What is the lot quality? This lot quality, this is unacceptable lot. This lot quality is known as, for producer risk, it is known as AQL, acceptance quality level. Now, lot quality related with this consumer risk, it is called as LTPD, lot tolerance percent defective. Now, if you are having 16 parts, 17 parts, 18 parts, 20, and so on, out of 100 defective, that is unacceptable lot. That is LTPD value. 16, 17, and so on, whatever the value we are getting, that is LTPD values. Getting these two terms, AQL and LTPD, these are the corresponding values for producer risk and consumer risk respectively. Producer risk is a probability. Okay, consumer risk is a probability. Producer risk denoted by alpha, consumer risk denoted by beta. This is the first one, producer risk. Graph value. Graph.
Percentage
त्यानुसार दिस इज वी गॉट फ्रॉम एक्सपेरिमेंटल इन्व्हेस्टिगेशन. हे डेटा ज्या वेळेस आपण कलेक्ट केलेला आहे, बेस्ड ऑन दॅट वी हॅव ड्रॉन दिस ग्राफ. बेस्ड ऑन वी हॅव इन्स्पेक्टेड नंबर ऑफ पार्ट अँड वी हॅव फाउंड दॅट फॉर 5% वी आर गेटिंग दिस मच, फॉर 3% वी आर गेटिंग दिस मच प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ ऍक्सेप्टन्स. दिस इज फ्रॉम एक्सपेरिमेंटल इन्व्हेस्टिगेशन. दिस चार्ट, दिस ग्राफ वी आर गेटिंग फ्रॉम एक्सपेरिमेंटल इन्व्हेस्टिगेशन. ओके, सो दिस इज अ AQL. दिस लेवल इज AQL. This is related with the producer risk. The level of lot quality related with the producer risk, that is acceptable level that consumer want to accept, okay, that is AQL. And the level of lot quality that consumer don't want to accept, that is called as LTP, that is related with the consumer risk. So these are the two terms from which we'll know the importance of your sampling plan. Now, performance of sampling plan is determined by using one parameter that is called as average outgoing quality. Performance of any sampling plan is determined by using one parameter that is called as average outgoing quality. And that average outgoing quality is given by probability of acceptance, percent defective, lot quality level. On x-axis, on y-axis, we will get this value. On x-axis, we will get this value into lot size, sample size divided by n. So this is average outgoing quality. So this is just product of main these two terms. Okay, so what exactly we are getting from this term average outgoing quality? If you are sending a lot of 100, so what is the average outgoing quality of that lot? So sender will know the quality level in that lot. So that we are getting from this parameter average outgoing quality. So that is nothing but the average of rejected lots. Suppose 100 components, 100 lot size, your 100, you are random sample size is 3, you have inspected 3 parts and 3 parts found defective. So we are taking average of this rejected lot. We are carrying out 100% inspection for reject lot. Whatever the part rejected, for that we are carrying out 100% inspection. Okay, and the accepted lot, whatever the lot accepted, now that accepted lot contains many defective parts. Whatever the accepted lots we have accepted, still it contains some defective parts. Okay, so we are taking average of that. So we'll getting empirical formula for that. Average outgoing quality is given by probability of acceptance into percent defective into lot size minus sample size divided by lot size. Okay, so where PAC, probability of acceptance, P percent defective or fraction defective, and sample size and lot size. Okay, now whatever the maximum value of that, as we know that this is nothing but the mainly product of probability of acceptance, percent defective. This AOQ is a product of parameter on x axis and parameter on y axis. Is a product of lot quality and probability of acceptance. Okay, so if you plot the graph, we will get the probability of average outgoing quality graph. So if you plot that graph, we will get the graph like this one. As the lot quality goes on decreasing, the average outgoing qualities are first goes on increasing and then goes on decreasing. So this, whatever the level, this level is known as average outgoing quality. This level is known as average outgoing quality. So at this level, this product is maximum. Probability of acceptance percent defective level is maximum at this lot quality level, and that is known as average outgoing quality level. This is this value of AOQ. What is AOQL? There are two terms, AOQ and AOQL. Average outgoing quality, average outgoing quality level. Maximum value of AOQ is known as AOQL. We are having this parameter P. Now this we are going to vary. If this is going to vary, this is also going to vary. So product, as this value goes on increasing, this product goes on increasing first, and there's going on decreasing. Okay, so that's why for every P we are getting different values of AOQ. So if you plot that graph, you will get the graph like this one, and this is the value that is known as AOQL. This is the maximum value of AOQ. This is a graph of AOQ values. We are having, this is the maximum value of AOQ, and that is known as AOQL. Max AOQ is known as AOQL. Okay, remember that maximum AOQ, maximum value of AOQ is known as AOQL, average outgoing quality level. So this is the significance of this parameter. We'll come to know for a single, for a given sampling plan, what is the average outgoing quality level. From this parameter, the sampling plan is designed. While designing the sampling plan is a trial and error process. Deciding N, capital N, small n, C, all these are trial and error parameters. So while deciding that, we'll get acceptable level of AOQL, then we'll design the plan. Okay. So AOQL, this is the parameter based on which a design parameter of sampling plan are finalized. It is a performance parameter of sampling plan. Single word, we can say performance parameter of sampling plan is given by AOQ, average outgoing quality. Max value of that AOQ is average outgoing quality level. Okay. We'll solve one numerical based on this. Write down. So this is the average outgoing quality level graph. Okay. Max value, that is AOQ. Write down, define AOQL and AOQ. Define AOQL and AOQ for the given data. Average outgoing quality level. Define theoretical definition. It is asking for theoretical definition. Define average outgoing quality level and AOQ. Average outgoing quality. Question end. Next question, that is, for the given data, calculate. For the given data, calculate sample size. And AOQ for single sampling plan. Sample size and AOQ for a single sampling plan. Now given data is probability of acceptance for 0.3 percent defective in a lot is 0.558. Probability of acceptance for 0.3% defective in a lot is 0.558. Lot size, that is capital N, was 10,000 units. NP, that is product of sample size and percent defective, 1.5. Selection or rejection criteria, that is C, is equal to 1. One additional information is given. Defective found in the samples are not to be replaced. After inspection, we are putting that in a given original lot. Okay. Defective, it is defective found in a sample are not to be replaced. Whatever the defective we found, again we are putting that in the same lot. Okay, we are not making replacement for that. This is additional information given to the sample data. Okay, so what is given? We have to determine sample size and AOQ. So two parameters we have to determine. From the given data, it has been asked. From the given data, it has been asked to calculate N. And one more thing, that is, what has been asked? What we have to calculate, we have to determine from the given data. First, that is sample size, that is denoted by small n. Then what next ask? That is AOQ, average outgoing quality. So these are the two things we have to calculate. These are the two things that we have to calculate. How to solve? First, how to calculate small n? How to calculate small n? Can we calculate from the given data? First, write down the, this is a